Hi everyone, welcome to Carpe Diem Sailing. My name's Marco, I'm a Sail Canada cruising instructor, and in today's video, we'll be talking about headsails, jibs, and genoas. And if you're enjoying the content, please like and subscribe. If you have subscribed, make sure you hit the little bell icon. That way you'll be notified of all our upcoming videos. For free downloads of the diagrams used in this video, as well as notes and checklists, please visit our website at www.carpediemsailing.com. And now, let's get started. To clarify, headsails are fore and aft sails carried forward of the mast and come in various shapes and sizes. Most commonly, they are referred to as jibs and genoas. There is also a specialized headsail called a staysail. Genoas are large overlapping sails. Jibs are smaller. And a storm jib is a specialized headsail for use in extreme conditions. Headsails, particularly genoas, are often referred to in percent. This percentage is a reference to the area or square footage created by the fore triangle. That being the forestay, the deck, and the mast. The area of the fore triangle is equal to 100%. In these examples from our teaching boat, we see the size of a 100% working jib, a 135% genoa, and a 150% genoa used in the lightest winds. Like the mainsail, the head is at the top of the sail, and the bottom edge is called the foot. The tack is the forward corner, and the clew is the aft corner. The luff is the leading edge, and traditionally the sail was connected to the forestay at the luff by clips called hanks. The leech is the aft or trailing edge of the sail. There is normally no boom or outhaul. The sheet ties into the sail directly at the clew, then leads through a fair lead to a winch. The halyard is the line that raises the sail to the top of the mast. The telltales are at the luff of a headsail and indicate wind flow over the sail. And finally, roller furling allows you to simply roll the sail up at the end of the day, rather than raising and lowering it and then having to fold it and stow it. Roller furling can also be used to reef or shorten sail to match increasing wind speed and is the most popular choice for cruising sailors. More on the advantages and disadvantages of roller furling to come later in the video. Now, to review and reinforce the material, let's take a look at the parts once again on our teaching boat. The head at the top, and the bottom edge the foot. The tack at the forward corner. The clew, with its attached sheet, is at the aft corner. The luff is the leading edge, and the leech, the trailing edge. The halyard raises the sail. The telltales on a genoa are at the luff. And the draft stripes help shape the sail. And finally, we have the roller furling system. Here is a demonstration of a roller furling system in use. A roller furler should always roll smoothly and easily. I'm rolling it up single-handedly while keeping light tension on the genoa sheets to ensure a tight wrap. I finish the furl with a couple of turns of the sheets around the sail to keep it from unfurling accidentally. A roller furling system can be used as a reefing system, and there are pros and cons. First, the pros. The sail can be shortened from the cockpit, which means it's safer. Since you're essentially turning the sail into a jib, you don't have to carry as many sails, and it's a lot easier to roller furl a sail than to change it, especially in adverse conditions. Now the cons. The sail shape, as you can see from the wrinkles in this photo, is compromised, and upwind performance will suffer. The telltales disappear as they get rolled up in the sail. There are systems available, such as AeroLuff, that help with sail shape, but I will leave that for a later video, specifically on shortening sail. And that brings us to the end of this video. If you enjoyed the content, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. If you have subscribed and would like to be notified of new releases, make sure to click the little bell icon next to the subscribe button. And why not check out our website for more comprehensive online courses? Thanks for watching. Until next time, I wish you all fair winds and following seas. I look forward to seeing you again soon for episode 7, Cooking Safety While at Sea.